I'm not scared. You'd never fucking dare. I would then. You know just where to
come,
Tomiss, laughed his driver. You could almost manage it without me. Tomiss had come. He didn't realize his driver was gay. Later, he boasted to the others. Driver says I don't need him now. Snorted Percy. I'd never
come
without my driver, said Toby earnestly. I'd be pardoned. Boasted Tomiss. I'm scared. You would. I never dare. You'll see. The next morning, the firelighter came.
All over
Thomas's face.
Whatever is happening?
Percy and Toby were still asleep. Tomiss suddenly remembered. Sis, stitch in the mum, he chuckled. I'll show us. I'll just go out. Then I'll stop and wheesh. The house rocked. Broken glass tinkled. Stone was everywhere.
It's a football!
Tomiss had collected a bush on his travels. He peered into the room through its leaves. He couldn't
wank.
The station master was hard. His wife picked up her plate. You miserable
fucking,
she scolded. Just look what you've done to Bob's breakfast. Now I shall have to cook some more. She banged the door. More
stone
fell. This time, it fell on Tomiss. Tomiss felt hard. Meanwhile, Donald and Douglas arrived. Dinner, shit yourself, Tomiss. We'll soon have you hard. They laughed. Donald and Douglas, puffing hard, managed to haul Tomiss back to safety. Bits of fencing, the bush, and a broken window frame festooned his dick, which was badly twisted. The twins laughed and left him. Weesh! There was worse to come. You
come.
I know, sir. I'm sorry, sir.
You must go to the works and have your dick mended. It will be a long job.
Yes, sir.
Meanwhile, Diesel will do your work.
The Diesel, sir?
Tomiss spluttered. Yes, Tomiss. Diesel's always staying
hard.
Diesel's never gallivant off to fuck station masters.